Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. I'm pretty speechless, so I had prepared quite a notes here, but I will just start out very simply, like, what attracted you? You could have had any profession you want with all the long list. So what attracted you to become a film director? And yes.
I think to tell these kind of stories, yeah. I mean, I think this is the best profession in the world where you can live so many lives through others, through the characters, and by exploring other human beings, their psyche. So in one lifetime, you can be two sisters, you can be a gangster, you can be a policeman, and you can be anything you want. So this is, I think, to explore a beautiful species called human being.
Great, great. So as you all know, Mr. Bhardwaj has directed Makbul, Haider, Omkara, and a long list of films. So before we get into some Q&A about the film, would you like to talk about some of your favorite films? And
No, I mean, I think, the as they say, the youngest kid is your favorite kid. So I made this with a lot of love, and right now this is my favorite film.
Oh, wow. And what inspired you to make this film?
Actually, I read a short story, and the short story was by a very, very good writer in Rajasthan, and he teaches in a primary school in a village. And when I read this short story, you know, I was laughing throughout when I read it. And then I met that writer for acquiring the rights, and I asked him, because, you know, it's very difficult. We all have siblings, we all have sibling rivalries, we have fights. But this kind of relationship, and in the detailing of that story and that life, was so beautiful and detailed and deep that then I asked him that, you know, how did you explore these two sisters? Where did you meet this character? Because this is very difficult to imagine a relationship like this. So he said that his two brothers are married to two sisters. And he has seen these sisters for in his house, and the fights used to happen like this. And he kept taking notes of you know, all those fights and the relationship. And that's how the short story ended. I have heightened it, of course, that hysterical blindness and aphonia. But when they actually, you know, when they were apart, they actually fell sick. And, you know, one stopped eating, and the other, you know, she started having an imaginary pain in her knee, and the doctor said there's no problem with them because they're absolutely fine. And one fine day when they came together for a festival, they fought again and they became absolutely okay. This is how this short story ended. So I thought it's a very, very beautiful, you know, way of expressing that how they can't live with or without each other. The love, the bond is so deep. So this is why, you know, I thought it's a very unusual story, and I tried to find references in my own cinema, and I didn't find any this kind of reference of a sibling rivalry like this. So I thought it's a very unusual story. It's very easy to for me to make, you know, I could have made another Shakespeare, or I could have made a romantic film or a thriller or espionage, but I thought it's a very unusual story to bring to the screen.
Thank you. And one thing, every film that we watch of yours is we are blown away by the acting of all the actors who you really bring out the acting in them. So how is there a trick how you direct them? Because these actors, they're not that well known, if I may say.
But they both are new, you know. One girl, that's her first film, the elder sister. This is her first film. And the younger one, she has done a small part, of course, in a very big film, Dangal. So she was trained in dialect, and she had workshopped. But the other girl is absolutely, so the one is one film old and the other is absolutely.
So do you have a training or?
Yeah, we have workshops. We had a lot of workshops, and they had to gain weight. So we had to take a break in between the film for say 6 weeks, and they gained around 8 to 10 kgs. So so that kind of that kind of commitment I needed from the actors. So that's why I went for the new girls.
Yeah, and teeth, right? I couldn't help but notice their teeth.
Yeah. So I wanted them to, let go of all the vanity and, of being a so-called the Bollywood beauties. So, and they were playing characters, and mm-hmm. so and they agreed for that, and we all had fun, and yeah.
Yeah. Just one more note, and I'll open it up to the audience. Before you came, I just announced that our Deputy Consul General of India and Deputy Consul General of Pakistan, they're both sitting here together.
Yeah,
so I want to acknowledge that and want to point it out to you.
Yeah, I was so happy to know that. I thought this is the best film to show to our... both the council. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for being here.
We will bring them out after the Q&A and do the award ceremony. So, yes, let's not wait and open up the question to all of you. And if you all could line up on each side, and we will pass the microphone. So, there are mic runners.
I have
mic. Okay.
Great. It's an honor to be in your presence. I greatly appreciated the film. Question I have is, I think you've explored a very delicate thread that binds humanity together. And the character of Dipper pretty much has little things to say where the ego sort of identifies itself with various things around us, and it can break the thread. And in the end, you've actually explored that war is probably the only way to bring lasting peace. Was that more by design, or was that more sort of following the writer's ideas? Can you comment on that, please?
In any case, the ultimate last resolution of the film is that they come together, they come to know that how much they love each other. So it's not about the war, it's about the peace, how they realize themselves that how deeply they love each other. So that was the whole thing, that was the message of the film. And that's why I think India and Pakistan we are like two sisters, we are two fighting sisters. We need to shed off our, enmity and come together and hug each other with love.
So thank you so much for sharing this film, wonderful film. And this is in the similar vein that the film was very much returned to the theme several times of India, Pakistan, and it had the first half of the movie raised the question in me, well, which sister is India and which sister is Pakistan? And it interestingly sidestepped that in the second part. Was there a reason that it didn't answer that question, or didn't kind of portray which sister was the Indian sister and which sister was the Pakistan sister?
Actually, we cannot, you can't differentiate between us. We are alike. We both are so alike. Yeah, when we meet, when we meet outside in America or England, I mean, you can't say that who is a Pakistani, who is an Indian. We are so much alike. The bond is so deep between us, between our cultures. We were one, and one day, we were divided by somebody else. So we are alike. So you can. That's why she, the bulky can be India and the other is Pakistan. That was not the point of the film. Thank you.
Hello. It's such a great pleasure, privilege to just be speaking to you, because I'm such a great fan of all your movies. I absolutely enjoy this film because I mean, I'm always on the lookout for female protagonists myself, so it was really nice to enjoy this because it goes beyond this whole vanity scene, and you know, it's so refreshing to see these women characters play out in this way. And I thought that, I mean, of course, you probably never came from this point of view, but for me, it was like, it's coming also from the point of view that it does a good service to feminism also, because, you know, you always keep seeing women in a particular frame, and this is completely different, more real, you know? And so this was enjoyable from that point of view. And because I also have this love-hate relationship with my brother, so for me, it was rooted in reality. And it was also very funny and amusing how, you know, they fight and so on. But I felt like, I read these critics and I felt that they thought that it could be very because they're fighting and fighting and fighting. But for me, it was not like that. It was actually very amusing. But what do you think is the reason some people think that it's, you know, it's there's too much of fighting on screen? Is it because, you know, we always look at women as though they should be, you know, like soft and nice, and this was very different from that. This was a far call from that. This is the first time we are probably seeing anything like this. So, what do you think?
I think, you know, if they had been two brothers, they would have never come back together. Yeah, because, you know, the men live by their head and women live by their heart, so they take it out immediately. And that's why they come back together also. And of course, you know, I am a feminist at heart. And that's why this, you know, in the village, Rajasthan is very close to Haryana, where the female infanticide is the highest and the honor killings are so much. Where two girls who are like, they are career oriented, one wants to become open a school, other wants to be open her business. So I really found that very, you know, interesting and charming, and that should be told. So this, and the husbands, you know, they are innocent and they are so much supportive to their wives. So I thought that we should have a different take of the female, the life in a village. Thank you.
Good evening, sir. First of all, I'd just like to start off by saying that I'm a huge fan.
Thank you.
Just absolutely, your movies are fabulous. My question would be, after watching this movie, is that while Chutki and Budki are India-Pakistan, the grandmom is supposed to be America. What is Dipper then? Like, which character is Dipper supposed to, I mean, which country is Dipper supposed to be? He's like such a layered character. I'm just interested to get your perspective on that.
He would be best England, you know.
Yeah, thank you, thank you.
You were asking a question.
Good evening, sir. Welcome to Seattle. I almost had the same question as her, but she went ahead first. Now my follow-up question for that would be, sir, why bring Dipper again and again to the movie? You see, Dipper was someone who just got entertained by just their fight. Is this to signify or personify the human instinct of, you know, India, Pakistan? Every time we see each other, we're like, let's do something or fight. Was that to signify that? Because Dipper himself said that, mere liye to entertainment hai, maza aega, ladengi, acha lagega, you know?
Actually, you know, we have so many Narad Munis in our general life. We have so many Iagos in our, and actually this character is somehow, you know, I can call him like a good-hearted Iago, that who make them fight, but finally he brings them together also. When they are stuck in the marriage with that pervert, he makes both of them run, and he lies over there, and you know, he and with a good intention, he lies to Balki that the result of the toss was she has been deceived by that toss, and he knew the father didn't, but he, in order to make her run, because the daughter was feeling so much burdened by her father's loan that she didn't want to run away. She could have run away, and he knew that's why he lies to her and make her run away. and so does he do with the younger one. So Dipper is, yeah, of course, you know, people take you know, enjoyment in when to make two people fight, and he's that kind of Narad Muni character. But I mean, the whole film is not about politics. It's a very sublime layer of which I was trying. It was not part of the short story that sisters are like India and Pakistan. Actually, it came from when many people asked me, and my filmmaker friends, my writer friends, everybody used to ask after this script narration that why do they fight so much? And I tried to, you know, to explore the reason for their fights, and all the reasons, they were so shallow, whatever I found. And I think, and I realized that whatever reason I find is going to be shallow, because sometimes, you know, in the siblings, they even forget after fight, after 2 years, you ask them. When I fought with my brother, and I remember that fight, how we both fought. But after 5 years, you know, we both were asking each other what was the reason we fought so badly. So that's why I got irritated with everybody's question that why do they fight so much? And then I said, why India and Pakistan fight so much? And suddenly I realized after saying that line that this is the reason, that there is no reason.
Why America as a mother?
It was just a momentary, you know, I don't think. I meant that it's just, you know, to bring that momentary humor, nothing. And main line for me in that was that nobody has a solution for America. That was more important for me, yeah.
Hi there. I was able to relate to the movie a lot. I enjoyed it a lot. We are three brothers married to three sisters. And
wait,
those three sisters are from Pakistan and I'm from India.
Oh my God.
So the question for me is, I have two part questions. One is, I really like the girl's father character. He was trying to reconcile, but he was also very subtle. So I wanted your thoughts on what you thought about when you sketched his character. And the other question I had was, how did you get an idea of having Trump and Modi hugging each other in the background?
What was the first question?
The girl's father's character, like how did you sketch that character? The reconciliation aspect.
Yeah, you know, because the mother died when they were very young, and father didn't marry again. And just for this reason that he didn't want a stepmother for his daughters. He loved his daughters so much. And now, because the mother not being in the house while they were being raised, so they have, you know, they became very ferocious, and you know, we see that, you know, how they are. So when actually we were prepping for it, so Vijay Raz, who's playing father, he asked me that how do I play this character, because if I play as a father, you know, I should be very strict with them. And then I told him that you're a father, but you play it like a mother. So that's why, you know, we see him, you know, he's like a poor father trapped between these two, you know, fighting daughters. So, and what was the second question?
The Modi and Trump hug.
Yeah, because, you know, I thought it was a marriage of convenience, you know, when the husband say that we'll give you money for your dreams. So there was, and the American Institute was there, so we had this, you know, this poster lying somewhere in the institute. I thought it will be very good marriage of convenience at that point. They are two alike.
Three more questions.
Okay. First of all, thank you. It was a very lovely movie. I enjoyed watching it thoroughly. And what I'd like to say is, as is obvious, all of us can relate to it. I have a sister who's a year older, and we've been warring siblings. And then my grandfather used to call us warring nations growing up. And but you know what I could relate to most was the dad, because now I have kids of my own.
and then I can see how they fight, and then it breaks me. But what I really enjoyed in the movie was the character of the two women. The way they are portrayed, they're not portrayed as meek or subdued in any way, and you see the whole empowerment, and you see how strong they are, and they're not going to take any kind of anything. For, you know, you can't push them in a corner or whatever. And although the you see the love and affection that they have, you know, quite often in today's world on the social media, when you want to portray your love and affection, it's quite soppy, and then you have all these things of, oh, it's Raksha Bandhan, I love my brother, I love my sister. But then when you see something like this, which is very different, you know, where you see people who are strong characters, but at the same time, you know, and probably they have some difficulty in kind of opening up and saying, expressing their love. But then you do see that happen in the end. So what I'd like to ask you is, you know, how did you feel about portraying women in such a strong role? And, you know, would they be accepted by the public, and rather than show them, show a meeker side?
You know, two reasons for that. Because initially, you know, when I became filmmaker, my first film was in the year 2000. You know, we use female actors or characters like props. They were like either wives or girlfriends or sisters or mothers, and they were shown weak. I mean, filmmakers used them at their will whenever they wanted. So I thought, and what I experienced since my childhood, seeing from my mother to my girlfriends to my wife, I realized that women are more stronger than men. Men can be a very, he can look very strong physically from exterior, but internally his interiority is very weak. And in the time of crisis, I have seen the women come out stronger. They behave strongly than men. They lose their wit, but the women give, and women is the power behind a man. So this is what I thought. So that's why in all my films, I never use female characters as props. That's why I choose to make film with strong female characters, and they are less explored also.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Bhardwaj. Another magical storytelling moment. Before my question, Rita, thanks again for making moments like these happen for all of us in Seattle. Mr. Bhardwaj, a question about another movie of yours which blew my mind. 5 years ago, you made Matruka Bijli Ka Mandola, and I was blown away when I saw a Cadillac inside in a Punjabi field. So I had two questions for these 5 years, which I've always wanted to ask. One is, what inspired you to make a movie like that? And number two, tell us about the pink cow.
Actually, you know, it was loosely based on Brecht's play, Mr. Puntala and his man Mati. There was a play by Brecht. And I love that character in that drunkard which Pankaj Kapoor played, in that Mr. Puntila, who, you know, after a few pegs, he becomes a totally different person. And so there were two sides to him, which is like he's a totally a different person. He will exploit the farmers. And he's a very conjuice, he won't give any money to anyone. But after, say, like 4 or 5 drinks, he becomes a totally socialist, you know, and he's... So that character fascinated me a lot, and his relationship with his servant, Mr. Matti. That was the basis of that. And I wanted to find... you know, that relationship in my own culture, in my own country, and I wanted to say something about the land grabbing, because that land grabbing is such a big issue in our society, in our country, where you know, the urbanization, these buildings coming, and this concrete jungle which is happening, and what we are doing to our environment is just in the name of business and prosperity. That is very sad, and still now it's on a rise More so in next past few years, it has risen to a different level. So that was my, in a comedy, you know, I wanted to say a very serious, I wanted to tackle a very serious issue in a very comic genre. And the pink cow, you know, because I came to know that, you know, at the height of alcoholism, you start hallucinating things. And mostly you see pink elephants. But in my character, I thought it will be pink buffalo will be a very good substitute for that.
Thank you. Last question.
It's an honor to be here, sir. Love the movie. My question, sir, is not related to the movie, but you are a movie maker, you are a poet, lyricist, scriptwriter, singer. So is there any particular medium you prefer, and what do you like best? And also, I'm a huge fan of Rekha ji too. We should hear her singing more, so I hope she sings more. So those are the two things.
Yeah, Rekha, no, it's singing. This year, I think you will get more of her songs. And she's also very selective, you know. And I can't do anything about that.
Love her voice, yeah. Love her singing.
And I think I like music the most. Filmmaking is a very difficult job. And right from the inception, inception of the idea is not difficult, but then to write it and then to raise finance for it, the more you want your subject to be deep and subtle and profound, it becomes more difficult to raise money for that. So there's a constant fight happening, then you go and execute it, it's nightmare, and then you wait for the public judgment to, you are judged by so many people. So it's, filmmaking is a different kind of trauma you go through. Music is so satisfying. You're sitting in an air-conditioned room, you're making your music, and that gives you the peace. And so music remains my first love, and will remain my last love.
Thank you so much, sir. Love your body of works and love the movie. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
So thank you very much, and we will now do the award ceremony. So we'll get down from the stage for a second and then come back on.